Hey everyone, so it's been a few months since I did an update to my G.I. Joe Classified Series collection, and that's because tracking these things down is still a pain. Also, I work a day job, so that makes toy hunting a bit difficult unless I go after work, but I'm too exhausted to do anything after work, even on my days off, because I actually do work, unlike most people that work at my job. Anyways, I have about four boxes here to, I guess, open up in this video to show you what I have finally got added to my collection. But first, I want to do a little recap on the characters that I already own in my possession. This, I don't know if this really counts. This is just something I found at Walmart one day. They have tons of these small, like, what are these, like 2-inch die-cast G.I. Joe figures. I thought it was really cool, so that's why I picked this up. It was when I was looking for classified figures one day, and of course they had none on the pegs. So let's go through these again before I open up the four boxes I have as part of this mail call video. So I do have the Baroness with Cobra Coil. Now Hasbro did mention that they will be re-releasing these or reissuing these or something at Target, so hopefully that's true. I don't know how much of that I really believe. I don't know if I really care anymore. All I got to say about that is I'll begin to care if there's an entire toy section dedicated to G.I. Joe figures, then I'll care. But for now, it's like, if I get the new figures, I'll get them. If I don't, I don't. That's cool. There's too many other action figure lines to get into. But yeah, very lucky to get this one. Very happy to have her as part of my collection. And I would not be surprised if there will be another one in her red costume instead of black. All right, let me lower the camera a bit. There we go. Oh, I did pre-order all of the Snake Eyes G.I. Joe Origins movie wave. So I will be getting Snake Eyes, Storm Shadow, I think her name's Akiko, or I forgot her name. Excuse me if I got that wrong, by the way. Baroness, even though it's like pre-Baroness where she has short hair, but it's still part of the classified line, so I still want to collect her. And I think there was one more. There was, there's the three females, actually. Scarlet. Yeah, Scarlet's going to be in that movie. So yeah, those three along with Snake Eyes and Storm Shadow pre-ordered the entire wave. So let's just go through these real quick before I show you the new ones that I finally have added. So I have Roadblock. I also have the Cobra Island Roadblock somewhere here. There we go. Okay, so Hasbro did release two more Roadblocks. Another version of the Wave 1 Roadblock, but he's repainted in a different Deku, and there's gonna be another Cobra. No, not Cobra Island. It might be Cobra Island. I'm not sure if it's Cobra Island or not. It's an Amazon exclusive Roadblock where he comes with his helmet and he comes with not a railgun, but a minigun. So two more Roadblocks out there. I might look into getting the Cobra, or I keep calling it Cobra Island, the Amazon exclusive version. If I get it, I get it. If I don't, I don't. It's cool. I don't really care anymore. hunting these things down has just been not fun lately. So I do have a Destro from Wave 1, and I have the Prophet Defender Destro over here, I believe. Prophet Director. For some odd reason, I keep calling him Prophet Defender instead of Prophet Director, so that's my fault. Alright, so, both Destros, that's really awesome. And there's so many other action figure lines to get into and collect, that's why I just barely just care anymore about actively going toy hunting for these. Unless they show up online, which certain ones have been popping in and out of stock, and that's how I was able to get lucky with some of the new ones I'm going to open in a few more minutes. So I do have Snake Eyes and Duke, and they have released numerous Snake Eyes. There's the Hasbro exclusive Snake Eyes. There is a special Fortnite one coming out that I did pre-order. There is the brand new one that they just mentioned. He comes with Timber the Wolf. And he has like his classic mask, or it's made to look like his classic mask. So, yay. And I think there's another like version of this one, but he has different paint applications on parts of his body. Also, there will be another G.I. Joe figure with a vehicle getting released that they just announced, and it's Breaker with his motorcycle. It's going to be a Cobra Island exclusive, or Target exclusive, but a Cobra Island figure, which means it's going to be difficult to track down. So, you know, if they pop in and out of stock online, I'll get it. If I miss out on it, no big deal. Because the next action figure line I want to get into is the... I forgot what it was called. It was the Masters... It was Masters of the Universe, but they had a particular name for it. I think it's called the Masters Universe or something like that. Well, anyways, it's based off the new Kevin Smith He-Man animated series that's going to be airing on Netflix later this month or next month or so. I think it's called Masters... Oh, I can't remember the name. Why am I blanking out on the name? But it's Masters of the Universe. Brand new toy line is coming out. I saw those, and it seems like fans are mixed. So hopefully that means a lot of them will be on the pegs because a lot of fans won't go for them. But I know how these things go. I've been collecting a long time. Usually fans will say a design looks ugly and they will not be collecting them. And then when the toys actually come out, they rush to the stores, see it in hand, and they buy it. So yeah, I definitely want to get into the new Masters of the Universe line. And there's going to be two separate ones. There's going to be one for kids and the one that's going to be intended for older viewers, I guess, because the new series is going to be based off the original series, so it's sort of like a continuation of that. Oh, Cobra Commander and Scarlet was not able to get the retro Cobra Commander with the lighter blue paint because I guess they canceled my pre-order and they said it's gotten delayed till a much later month, so I was like, screw it, I don't even care about it anymore. As for Snake Supreme Cobra Commander, supposedly, that's in one of the boxes I have off to the side of the camera that I will open up here in a few minutes. And, oh, as for Scarlet here, the lovely Scarlet, well, when I was trying to order Roadblock right here from Amazon, they sent me Scarlet instead. And I was just too aggravated and just too tired to just go through the whole return process, so I decided to keep her. And as for Roadblock here, I ended up getting him off eBay because, you know, at least they had photos up on eBay and you know what you're getting. However, sometimes that's not always the case. So yeah, I have two Scarlets in my possession and now I have two Cobra Commanders. I finally have the Snake Supreme Cobra Commander I always wanted because I put my pre-order in for that last year and I didn't get it until this year. Yeah, because I guess the whole pandemic slowed things down a bit. Alright, so I have Beachhead and Zartan. Very cool additions to my collection here. And there goes the whole collection. One moment, please. Alright, I apologize for that. Continuing on, I have Gung-Ho and Red Ninja. Very happy to at least acquire one Red Ninja because people have been army building this guy like crazy, and it's been driving me crazy when people army build stuff, but hey, whatever, there's no limit to these things when they sell them at retailers, you know, and it's within a collector's right to buy multiple amounts of the same figure, especially when it's an army building figure. Anyways, those two are gonna fall, aren't they? Nope, they're staying up. Okay, good. So I also have Arctic Mission Storm Shadow, which was a Amazon exclusive, but I think you can get them at other websites like Big Bad Toy Store, and there's another website I think you can get them from, but mainly from Amazon. And I have the Cobra Trooper here, the special Cobra Island Cobra Trooper, not the reissued one where he comes with less stuff. That one, however, I heard you can find at Walgreens. I have yet to find any G.I. Joes at my local Walgreens. All right. And finally, I do have Firefly and Cobra Viper. All right. So that took up 10 minutes. Yikes. And where did I put Baroness? Oh, she's behind me. I'll put her up there for now. So let's get to the mail call portion. I have these boxes right here from Amazon and one right here from Target. I'm worried about this one from Target because this is supposed to be my major blood figure. They sent it in a very big box. I hope they didn't make a mistake. All right, so let's get to these smaller boxes first. All right, now I need my pair of scissors. All right, so hope you guys are enjoying the video so far. Hope you guys are finding these figures a lot easier than me. A lot of them were just based off lucky toy hunts, and a few of them, yeah, acquired from online retailers, like the Storm Shadow there. And what other ones did I get from online? I'm trying to think. Roadblock. A lot of these I did find from Target. I don't believe I found any of these at Walmart except for the first wave. Yeah, Snake Eyes. I almost called them Storm Shadow, but Snake Eyes and Destro, I both got from Walmart when they first came out. And that's when I first saw the entire wave there, wave one, but I only bought those two at the time because I didn't feel like spending a lot of money. You know, I was like, yeah, you know, I'll save up money. I'll buy the other ones at a later time. And little did I know, these things were going to be a pain to find in stores and online. Like, man, you know, Hasbro, they have a lot of money, right? I'm pretty sure they make enough profit off their Marvel Legends and Star Wars figures. So why not make a crap load of these and, you know, ship them out to stores? But then I found out that the retailers were not ordering enough G.I. Joes, such as Target. And I just don't understand that. Like, why not order enough figures when there's such a high demand for them? But they did mention there will be a reissue of certain figures. Certain ones will get re-released inside Target. Like I said, I don't really care unless there's an entire section dedicated to G.I. Joe figures because, well, I don't know about anyone else's Target, but my Target only has two pegs where G.I. Joes would normally go. So to me, that's not enough. That's not enough. They at least need an entire section, or at least half of an entire section with multiple pegs just filled with G.I. Joe classified series action figures. But anyways, so this one I just took out of the box. I have no idea what it is or who it is. Oh, it's Flint. So I could finally add Flint to my classified series collection. Comes with his beret there, and is that a shotgun? Looks like a combat shotgun, and it comes with a handgun. It looks pretty cool, actually. That's all the weapons he comes with. I'm actually shocked. So this guy, I was able to acquire from Amazon for retail price, by the way. So I got him for the regular $19.99 sales price. Then I had to pay an arm and a leg. All right, so time to open up the next one. Let me see. Some shipping information is on a sticker on the box. So let me just kind of move that stuff out of the way. I think we're good. Nope, we're not good. Okay, we should be good now. All right, so this box right here, I can't remember which one I ordered, and I don't know which retailer this is from, but we're gonna find out together. All right, look at this. There we go. Hold on, let me move that out of the way. Remove some private information. Okay. And it looks like I have acquired Lady J. That's awesome. So Lady J comes with spears? Those are spears, right? Because I see spearheads, and I see the handles of the spears. She comes with a knife. Not sure what that is, a detonator of some sort, a hat, a gun, and a backpack. Oh, and there's a thing attached to that backpack. That's pretty cool. Lady J. So, this one I acquired from GameStop, I believe. I got her. I wouldn't say super early, but just a little bit early before she start hitting retailers in other locations, not my location, because my location sucks when it comes to distribution. Anyways, all right, so next up, let's see here, this box, and I think I know who this is. This one came from Hasbro Pulse when they finally got around to fulfilling some of my pre-orders from last year. Jeez. Which kind of aggravated me because a lot of people who ordered figures from Hasbro Pulse last year actually got their figures towards the end of last year, and some of my stuff I'm not getting until this year. Ugh. So frustrating. But I get it. You know, I guess the whole pandemic and everything. Ugh. Come on, come on, come on. Hope I didn't damage the box with scissors. Oh crap, the box is right there too. Shoot. I think it's okay. Hopefully I didn't cut anything of the box. So, this one, I am very happy to acquire. And that is Snake Supreme Cobra Commander. So I'm not quite sure. Oh, there's the front of it. Okay. That's cool. I had no idea this was the, I thought this was the front, but that must be the back. This is the front. So here he is, Snake Supreme Cobra Commander. That looks so awesome. I love the box. All right, so this just opens like this. Oh, that looks sick. Oh, I love the colors on him so much. Just so, so much. And his accessories as well. That looks so sick. So to show you guys a comparison, where did I put the regular Cobra Commander? Can I remove that without knocking everything over? Let's find out. Easy. Easy. I did it. Okay, awesome. So there we are. Regular Cobra Commander and the Snake Supreme Cobra Commander. In his repainted colors, and he comes with a he comes with an awesome cape. I was trying to combine the word awesome and cape into one word and say cossum. Alright. So, yes, I'm so happy. So, so happy to have this guy as part of my Classified Series collection. At least I'm happy to acquire just one. Because some people are nuts to buy multiple amounts of these and, I don't know, for whatever reason, I guess, try to resell these or army build them for extra parts. Me, I'm a one figure or one per character type of guy when I collect these figures. But that is pretty damn cool. Alright guys, the final package to open up as part of my mail call for G.I. Joe Classified Series action figures, and it should be Major Blood. But here's the thing, the box is a little bit too big, so I'm a bit worried they sent me something else, so I figured this would be fun to save for a YouTube video, just in case if they actually did send me the wrong thing. I hope not, because this box is a little bit too big for Major Blood. It should not be this huge. And yeah, Major Blood was a pain to acquire, because multiple people in other toy hunting videos have found like so many of him on their pegs at their targets. And there's none at my targets, and I've been going week after week, but no Major Bloods. And he's been popping in and out of stock on Target's website one day, and I was like, okay, I just gotta keep refreshing. And he was in stock a few times, but every time I clicked the ship it button to ship it to my house, or you know, the buy it button, whatever, sold out instantly, or my cart would be empty. So I had to spent like almost an entire day refreshing friggin' Target's website So I finally got one in my cart and was able to purchase one. Ugh, I swear, man. Collecting figures should not be this damn difficult. There's some information in there I have to remove off the side of the camera. Alright, well, I do see a G.I. Joe figure in there. But what the hell else is in there? Is it Major Blood? It is Major Blood! We have acquired Major Blood. The latest one to come out, and there's nothing else. That is a waste. That is a waste of a lot of plastic and cardboard and a lot of space in there. Like, look at this. Look at this. They could easily fit multiple amounts of other figures in there, but there's nothing. Wow. Okay, I'm guessing they ran out of the perfect size box to fit this in. But anyways, who cares? Finally got Major Blood. I was shocked I was able to order him off the Target website, first of all. Because usually I miss out on these since, you know, I'm always busy or sleeping from exhaustion. And of course, he is a Cobra Island figure, which means he is a Target exclusive, blah. But from what I've seen in other people's videos, they're restocking Target shelves. He's getting out there, but I guess that depends where you live. Like I mentioned earlier, distribution in my area sucks. It really does. So I have to resort to online methods or just constantly driving to the store week after week and being disappointed after finding nothing. So there he is. Major Blood. Alright, so that's it for this mail call update video for my G.I. Joe Classified Series collection. As for the latest action figures that just got announced by Hasbro, Snake Eyes with Timber, the new Roadblock, and Breaker with the motorcycle. Hey, if I acquire them, I acquire them. If I don't, I don't. I'm not going to make a big deal out of it. If I miss out on them, there will be other opportunities in the future to get those action figures. Like I said earlier, there is so many other things to be into right now because it's a great time to be an action figure collector. And, you know, if there's any other future figures that might potentially come out, like Dr. Mindbender or Serpentor, oh, I would love to collect those as well. And I don't know if I'll actively search for them. I mean, of course I will, but you know, I'm not gonna go out of my way and drive to multiple Targets like I used to, especially now that I have a day job. It's kind of difficult to do that. But for now, I want to get into the Mastersverse with the brand new He-Man figures and collect a bunch of those. And I'm not sure what else I'm getting into right as now. Well, actually, I recently got back into Marvel Legends a little bit, so I have been buying a few Marvel Legends here and there. I bought some of the Shang-Chi wave. I bought MODOK. I think it was it a few months ago? A few months ago, I bought Thanos. And I think there was more coming out that I... Oh, right. There was the Disney Plus series wave with the WandaVision characters. And there's Falcon and Winter Soldier characters, but technically, Falcon is the new Captain America, so Captain American Winter Soldier? anyways, thank you for watching, happy collecting, and I need to end this video and edit some things down. I cut a lot of stuff down. Alright, thanks everyone. Later.